boxing. The referee for this contest is John Raven, and the speaking hero, Andrew Reese. Introduces you to the first boxing icon, Bruno, Mr. Knight, Red Blue Shorts, official record, Evan Storm, 8 pounds and 4 ounces. He's the former national amateur champion of his All Nation Man Boxing Arm at Manchester. He has 1 win and 1 draw from 4 contests, with 1 win coming by way of knockout. It's the freedom fighter, Bahadur Karani! And introducing Boxing Arm at Manchester, red collar, wears the white collar and blue shorts, puts away to Evan Storm, 6 pounds and 1 ounce. He's the former national amateur champion of the UK and 4 times regional amateur champion, and defeated as a professional, 7 wins from 7 contests, 3 of those wins coming by knockout. From Burnley, Rhys
Thank you. Second down, and four.
Go!
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, I want to wait for your referee's decision. Let's please show our appreciation for both boxers. Ladies and gentlemen, the 6 half-hour winners will have to be John Wayfarer Scott's contest. 58 points to 57 points. Their winner, Rhys Van Hoy! Happy Open Sessions!
Rhys Farnell, hey, what a fight, that was. You know, he really came to he brought it there, and he, I mean, face there, I mean, look at that, it shows you've had a tough fight. Talk us through that.
Yeah, tough fight. I knew he was tough before getting in there. I knew he was going to come forward. I knew he was strong on scales yesterday. He looked strong. So yeah, came at me straight away. I felt he was strong. Obviously I got caught, I think it was head glass, I'm not too sure. And then after, I think it, either end of the first round or start of the second round, that eye was completely gone with blood in my eye. This eye was like a bit blurry, a bit of blood in it, so I just had to get onto my boxing. I love to stand there and have a tear up with somebody, but the best thing to do was just get on the jab, yeah. Just get through the fight, win it by jabbing. Yeah.
So you've learned a lot from that. I mean, yeah, I watched him recently in a fight live. He was and he got a draw against I think it's
Leighton.
Yeah, so you know he comes to the fight. I mean, you dug down there and bit on the gum shield, yeah, but yeah. You know, you'll take so much from that, won't you? As a
Rhys, it's easy to like just crumble under pressure in a fight like that. It's not going your way. It's easy to give in, but you know, I like to just grip the teeth, get stuck in, and have a good fight.
Yeah. I just spoke to his coach Sean, who I've known for a long time, and he asked me how I had it. I mean, I missed the first bit of the round because I was doing one of these interviews, but. A couple of other people say it was a really close fight, there's a point in it, so you know, how did you see it? What was it like being in there, and how did you feel once it ended? Do you feel like you'd done enough?
Yeah, well, in there I was thinking, oh, close fight this, when he went up close he would probably be doing the most work up close. Then when the last bell went, end of fight, I know I'd do enough with just my jab alone, you know, jabbing and moving, making him miss, making him fall short, yeah. Felt like I did enough, yeah. Deserved to win.
You're just progressing, aren't you? Getting better each fight. Yeah. I mean, what is that your 10th now?
That's my 8th, that.
That's your 8th? Yeah.
So, yeah, I've had some tough fights as well. Like, not, you have? Not 8 easy fights. You wouldn't class him as a journeyman, would you? You came to win. So, yeah, good. Yeah,
that's going to stand you in good stead. You're saying you've got a holiday on Monday.
Yeah.
Yeah, they'll let you so, let you through passport control. Yeah, you have to. I mean, you had you fought everyone in the amateurs, didn't you? Loads of pros who are going on to do well now and everything. Yeah, yeah. You've been in with loads of fighters. What's next for you? And, you know, what do you want next now? You're 8 now. You're looking next few fights and then maybe an area title, something like that?
Yeah, area title. Just whenever Kevin, you know, tells me. If it's next fight, I'll be happy to do it. You know, I feel like I've had enough experience now to get in there and have a crack at somebody. Yeah. You know, I'm not in this game for easy fights. I'd like to test myself, challenge myself, and put on good fights like that.
Good fights like that.
But people like seeing it, you know.
It was some fight, really. Credit to both of you, and everyone was up on their feet, and you know, it was one of them fights, a real good small all battle, yeah. So, Rhys, what's next? Holiday first, good meal.
Yeah.
Relax a bit and back in the gym, and then what would you like next? Is there anything in the pipeline?
Just 2 weeks off, have a bit of a rest, good food, like I say. Just at the start of this year, I just went full time boxing. So, after my rest, I'm straight back in gym, full time, just working away, just for whatever comes next.
So, you can concentrate now fully on your boxing?
Yeah, it's
fully not working as well as beside
it. Got a few good sponsors, Dougal Craig. That's a big sponsor.
Yeah, they've helped you out. That's great. So you can train now full time. So that's good of them. Yeah.
He supports me, so that's good.
That's what you need. Yeah, yeah. And still supporting Burnley. Yeah, Burnley getting behind Burnley. You.
Yeah, Lisa. Hopefully. Trying to.
Yeah, so they're not doing too bad, are they?
They're doing good, aren't they? Doing mint.
Yeah.
Yeah. Go on, hopefully get a big fight at Turf Moor one day. That'll be good.
Well, Rhys Farnell always comes. He brings it, and he's guaranteed excitement. And we look forward to seeing him back out again soon.
Awesome.
God bless him, my friend.